No one can really glorify that which is yet still. Yet still we go on glorifying. Try to understand this. All the poets, singers, masters go on glorifying Him. They go on without a break. Because in the process of singing or overflowing, one drowns, attains to the state of samadhi, but he cannot be described. Yet is still glorifying and chant the being. This is not only beautiful instant nectarine as well. It is so blissful that in the process the singer is no more. Instead, he dissolves in an unknown ocean of bliss. Rabindranath Tagore, Meera, Nanak, Kabir, they sang. Others, Lao Tse, Jesus, they did it in their own way. To explain to this state, the Sufi poet Allama Iqbal sings, Jo mai sarva sajda hua kabhi, to zameen se aane lagi sada. We bow down 5 times for a day as a Muslim to offer our namaz. It is incumbent on a Muslim to offer 5 times prayers. We bow down as a ritual. Jo mai sarva sajda hua kabhi kabhi, whenever, in a rare moment, I really bow down. In sajda. I am not talking about rituals. I am talking about when you bow down and a state of meditativeness comes in. The masters have shown. Rabia Basri has shown this. Shah Abdul Ghani Khan showed this. Jo mai sarva sajda hua kabhi to zami se aane lagi sada. I heard a cry, I heard a lament from the earth, a voice, a message from the earth came. Tera dil to hai aisanam ashna, thy heart is crystal clear like a mirror, its surface is clear to manifest that which is. When the surface of the mirror, which is the reflecting medium, gathers dust, it cannot reflect the image of that which is in front of it. When you are in prayer, you are to glorify, to reflect that which is. That is the meaning of the prayer. Through your gestures, through your ways and means, through the words that you speak, all these should become a mirror to reflect the glory of that which is. Zami se aane lagi sada, cry, a sound, the message came from the earth. Tera dil to hai ae sanam. Sanam is the word that we address to refer to the person out of love. Oh beloved, your heart is crystal clear. Its surface is clear, clean, without a speck of dust. What will you gain through such prayers, through such ritualistic acts? All effort of the masters is to make your heart crystal clear, without any speck of dust. The purpose of singing, the purpose of chanting, the purpose of zikr, mantras, is to make your heart a reflecting medium, shining. As soon as the moon appears, its reflection is clear, without any waver. If the water on the surface of the pond continues to shiver, shake because of the waves, and where the waves come from in an individual? from various psychocenters, the emotions, the organs of perception and organs of action. You remember something, waves begin to arise, you become restless, and you would have observed the moment a name comes to your mind, particular circumstance or situation comes to your mind, ripples begin to arise within. These are feelings. Certain feelings drown you and certain feelings make you restless. And when you are restless, the surface, the reflecting surface, becomes disturbed. It cannot reflect the image of that which is. The moment these feelings bring a calmness into you, a state when there is no ripple arising, the image does not break down, the image does not shake. In the process, many attain to samadhi. When you drown in the state of feeling, a feeling arises for someone or something, and you drown into that, you are lost into it, you dissolve into it, you become oblivious of your presence. Just remember and imagine your beloved. You drown, a feeling arises for him or her, and you drown in that feeling. You forget everything. All scriptures describe him, Vedas, Puranas chant his glory, learned one describe him, the milkmaid, the Govind, Vishnu, all describe him. Many masters describe him, yet still no one can really describe his glories. Men, saints and aspirants sing his glories as well. His description, his glories are not mere words to entertain you. It is a technique of meditation. When I spoke of this composition, जो मैं सर्व सजदा हुआ कभी तो जमी से आने लगी सदा तेरा दिल तो है ऐ सनम आशना तुझे क्या मिलेगा नमाज में. This is not to entertain, to clap when you are listening to it. This is the message, this is a remembrance to drown into it. A remembrance to drown into it. To attain to a state of meditativeness. This is a technique of meditation. His description is the way to drown in his subtleties. Overflowing him is a way to turn towards him. Whenever his message overflows, pause for a moment to listen. Maybe a drop of nectar may shower in your being. Maybe, breaking all barriers of deafness, a word may enter you. Maybe your blind eyes may be filled with light. And then for the entire life that echo continues in your ears. This is the reason Nanak goes on singing. Yesterday I heard in the talk at Gurdwara that Nanak composed the first prayer that occupies in Guru Granth Sahib. Nanak did not compose any. He is in a state of intoxication. All of a sudden something begins to overflow. When Holy Prophet, full of ecstasy, comes out from that communion with Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, whatever overflows out of him, the Sahibis wrote it out. And a composition of 23 years is known as Quran Pak, Quran Majid. Nanak did not say anything. He He did not write anything. Instead, he sang and he used music so that the inner sur or the tune may establish within you. Maybe in the musical melody, you attain to inner silence. And once you have tasted this, you will never forget. Nanak gives so much importance to the congregation of masters, and whenever and wherever his words overflow, Nanak insists to go to such congregations and listen. Maybe a word may enter you, maybe a message or something. Slowly and slowly you will be enchanted. If you pass through the garden, then your clothes will be filled with fragrance. It is impossible that you pass through the garden and beauty does not daze you, the fragrance does not reach your nostril. No matter how deaf, how lost in your thoughts you may be, a moment the fragrance finds an opening to enter your nostrils. The beauty finds a minute opening to enter you. Also, if you stand in front of the rising sun, the sun rays will even create ripples in you. And if you sit by the moon or lie under the moon, looking at the sky, then certainly the coolness of the moon will create grooves in you. That's why going to such places is very important. This is the reason Nanak again and again says, listen. Then he starts singing. In the process, Nanak again and again reminds you that the more one sings, the more one finds he is incapable. A beginning happens, but the end does not come. Rabindranath Tagore began, ushered an era, ushered a process, but the end never reached. Nanak sings and yet still says no description can define him. The scriptures all go on singing. All around there is music. The milkmaids, the cowherd boy, do not even say anything or sing. Instead, they dance. And in the dance, he glorifies. Ras Leela, the dance of the milkmaid and Krishna, happens under the moonlight on the bank of the blue river. Nanak says even this cannot describe him. This is a process to drown you in the remembrance, in the glory of that which is. Ways differ. Meditative silence of Buddha, the dancing feet of Meera, the songs of Nanak are all the ways to sing his glories. Meera sings. With dancing, sings and dances ecstatically. Dancing bells around her feet, a cymbal in her hand, a lute. She goes on singing. She goes on dancing. Buddha sits in silence, unmoved. There is no movement in him. Not even a ripple seems to be an image, mujassim, unmoved. Beauty. Sometimes, a poet says, sometimes let the dancing feet of Meera be quiet and start dancing. Sometimes the silent feet of Gautam may get into intoxicated dance. Whatsoever one is doing, kabhi Meera ke behakte paon thamne to do, kabhi Gautam ke sade paon rukne to do. One day I will encompass all this in my being. You cannot expect Buddha to dance like Krishna and Krishna to meditate like Buddha. Ways differ. Meditative silence of Buddha, the dancing feet of Meera, the songs of Nanak are all the ways to glorify him. Nanak says his description can never fulfill because God is not a finished happening. It is the process of creation. Creator is the process of creation. Only that which has attained fruition can be described. That which remains incomplete cannot be described. If the autobiography of someone has to be written, we have to wait until he dies. How can you write the autobiography of God? He is never born and never died. Therefore, how will you write the autobiography or sing his glories? The existence never comes to an end. The flowering, the blossoming of the flower never comes to an end. One flower blossoms, another one withers away. And this process of flowering and withering continues. Har band kali ko khilna hai, phir khilkar murjhana hai. Every closed bud has to blossom and then wither away. Therefore, listen to the wise. Har band kali ko khilna hai, khilkar murjhana hai. Every closed bud has to open and then wither away. Sai ki sada sunja baba. O fool, always listen to the man of wisdom. Dunya rang badalti hai Baba. The world keeps on changing its color moment to moment. A feeling comes that disappears like a wave, another wave arises. Dunya rang badalti hai Baba. Therefore, listen to the Master. Listen to the one man of wisdom. The existence never comes to an end. It goes on expanding. Flowers go on blossoming. New leaves go on appearing on the tree. God has infinite possibility of growth. All descriptions therefore remain incomplete. Hindus are unique. They have made such unique statues of God that has no feature. A Hindu picks up a stone, colors it red, and the stone becomes a symbol of Hanuman. I say symbol of Hanuman. Just as your handkerchief that has been given to you by your beloved, or the necktie, or the shirt, or the perfume becomes a symbol of the remembrance of, so too that stone becomes a symbol of Hanuman. Shivalingam have no features. This symbol is eternal. You can describe him, and even before you finish, you will find all descriptions has become outdated. If he has reached totality, then we can make a guess. He is ever expanding. Nothing can be forecasted about God. His glories are infinite. His account cannot be kept. A feeling arises within him and the things take place. Christians and Jews say, God willed and things happened. There is a time gap between your thought and or feeling and the action. You want to build a house, there is a gap between the feeling that arises within and the actual happening in the house. It may take some time. This explains human limitations. Time exists for man. For God, time is irrelevant. Time exists for you because you are weak. Time exists because of your weakness. For God, there is no time. You willed and it happened. Have you noticed something? As you get weaker and weaker, time goes on lengthening for you. When you are sick with high fever, time appears long. Your wife has high fever. You send someone for medicine. It takes just 10 minutes, but it appears the person has taken a very long time. Scientists are now studying what happens when someone is sick and why time becomes relatively longer. You are waiting, sitting by the roadside for someone. You feel time is passing and the person hasn't come. You sit by the side of a sick person and you will find a moment becoming longer. God is omnipotent energy field. As something is wished, it happens. His feeling is action. Bhav is the Hindi word for feeling is action. When you knows this, has envisioned it true. This can have two meanings. And Nanak's way, he continues to sing. As it is wished, it happens simultaneously. This has double meaning. One who knows this becomes an embodiment of truth. The other meaning explains only a true person can know him. You cannot know him. He is beyond birth and death. You know not his future or past, and he can never attain totality. He goes on expanding from totality to more totality. He is not moving from imperfection to perfection. One meaning is only he knows him. All our predictions are mere predictions. If I go on trying to say something about you, can I know about you more than what you know about yourself? No way. I can only describe you from the small window that I know. Each day, when you listen to the talks, you feel that you have not yet known, because each day something else, something deeper, something beyond your imagination is spoken. Therefore, only he knows him. All our predictions are mere predictions. And the other meaning explains one who realizes his omnipresence and omnipotent attains to truth. Nanak says, if a list of ignorant ones has to be prepared, then one who finds God can be described, has to be on top. Nanak goes on describing him. The description is blissful. Description drowns. Description is meditation. The more you describe, the bud of your heart starts opening its petals. The biological heart becomes the spiritual heart kalp. The more you describe, the bud of your heart starts opening its petals. Description creates ripples within. Wise is one who knows that no effort can describe him. He rejoices his remembrance. As the wise continues the description, his door starts opening for him. More and more petals starts appearing. Have you ever noticed when the first child is born, the mother only talks about the child? She keeps on repeating about the child to everyone who comes home. When a lover falls in love with the beloved, he goes on repeating and remembering again and again. And by repeating, love goes on deepening. The lover never thinks that he is repeating. You may get tired listening to someone speaking about his or beloved. Love deepens with repetition. This creates an echo around the beloved, as if a bee is humming around the flower. This happens, all that happens in ordinary love, something like that happens at a different plane when the direction of love becomes eternal. Nanak goes on singing, if you have not experienced love within you, you will not be able to understand Nanak. To you, Nanak will be repeating the message, same thing again and again. But Nanak is a lover who goes on singing, glorifying his beloved. Whosoever comes, he will keep on telling him about his beloved. Remember, once again Nanak repeats, never think that you can describe him. As this happens, you are the ignorant one. Nanak uses the word Gaurav. Gaurav means glorify. The illiterate village person. The more you sing, your ego will vanish, and then you will become wise among wise. In the process of description, if ego is nourished and you consider yourself the one who is describing, and you have finished the description, then once again you are ignored. Nanak goes on singing, jo main sarva sajda hua kabhi to zameen se aane lagi sada. Tera dil to hai aisanam aashna, tujhe kya milega namaz mein. This is the composition. The opening lines of it is, kabhi hai haqeeqate muntazar nazara hivaase mazaz mein. You are infinite. This infiniteness is your garb. No one can explain to that. Sometimes appear in finite form. Kabhi ay haqeeqate muntazar, O truth, O unmanifest, O infinite, sometimes attain the garb of the finite so that I can capture you. Kabhi ay haqeeqate muntazar nazara libaase mazaz mein. Mazaz means finite. Libaase mazaz, the garb of the finite. When something is infinite, how can you capture it? You have to have a telescopic vision to capture that infinite. The sky that contains myriads of stars, and it is only through the telescopic vision you can capture a faraway star and bring it closer to you. Kabhi ay haqeeqate muntazar nazara libaase mazaz mein, sometimes appear in the garb of finite so that I can capture you. I can try to encompass your infiniteness. And then, jo main sarva sajda hua kabhi namaz mein, jo main sarva sajda hua kabhi, when I really bow down my heart and pray, that very moment a cry, a lament starts coming from the earth, the lower centers. Your energy has now reached to the heart center. The biological heart has become kalb. Dil ka kalb ho jana. When the whole process is that of transforming the biological heart into spiritual heart. Dil is heart. Kalb is the spiritual heart. This is known as kalb zakir hona. The heart center is invoked. It is ready to reflect the glory of that which is. And that very moment you realize all this is ritual is futile. all this ritual is futile. The moment you understand the futility of it, and then you do it, is no problem. But we go on doing it as an ignorant one. His story goes on. Anecdote, Hazrat Maulana Shah Abdul Ghani Khan, the fellow disciple of Maulana Fazl Ahmad Khan, was alive. A Muslim came to him to discuss certain things, and same time the call for prayer came. So he said, "Sir, I want to offer the namaz. It's a time for prayer." Remember, the Sheikh is talking about, he is glorifying his beloved, and you all of a sudden say that it is time for my prayers. How would he feel that he does not know what prayer is? He said, "Yes, certainly you must go and offer your prayers, because it is incumbent on you to offer your prayers." He could not understand the sadkas. He said, "But today I want to offer my prayers behind you." He said, "Then there is no problem. Wherever there is a heart overflowing with love and beauty, that place becomes the mosque, that place becomes the temple. Your heart is the temple of God. That is the church, that is the temple." He said, "I do not go to the mosque. I will offer my prayers right here." What kind of namaz is this, he thought. But somehow the other, out of respect that he is a sheikh, whatsoever he says, let me accept it. Otherwise he will give an hour talk again on one issue. The first sajda, the first part of the prayer, finished, and he bowed down. In that state he remained for 1 hour. The person was surprised, "What kind of namaz is this?" He finished in namaz in 5 minutes, 6 minutes. But his one sajda took 1 hour. He said, "When I bow down and I remember the grace of my master, I forget all about the prayer. I remember his grace, how it showered on me and it invoked my, removed the callous from my heart, one tawajjuh, one energy field. And as I remembered that, I was drowned in that, and I forgot that somebody is standing behind me in prayer. And that's the reason that you have to remain in that state for a long time." But he could not understand. "I was not there, but I understood. You will understand this because you are in a totally different realm."